this video is about my gargoyles. And I'm going to start with this one that I already kind of pre-made. It's the armature right now. It's the skeleton before I do the paper mache. And it's something I just kind of made up as I went. I want it to maybe not fog, but even maybe mist or something come out of his mouth, and I'm gonna make little nostrils, and I want his eyes to glow. And since it's a paper mache, I wanted to make sure that if I'm putting in moisture inside, that it's not gonna deteriorate over time. So my idea was to use melt crates, or this is a water jug. This is the Arrowhead water jug. And what I did is I just cut out a face, I drew on what I wanted, and then the rest of it is a styrofoam cooler that I got for free. If you've seen any of my other videos, you'll know that I love getting stuff for free and making things out of nothing. I hardly spend any money on any of my projects. I got all this styrofoam here, I have another one here. All I did was just ask for it, and voila, it just appears. Or I go on You Got, that site that I was telling you about, Unconditional Give and Take, ask for the styrofoam. It's amazing how much styrofoam is out there in the world, which is kind of scary. This stuff never goes away. So I'd rather reuse it, recycle it, and make something fun out of it. So this is my gargoyle. Your armature can be made out of anything. It could be all cardboard if you wanted. It could be chicken wire. It could be newspaper. My vision was using the styrofoam because I wanted to set it on its side. And I wanted to put the little fog machine back here, like where this rock would be. It would feed up underneath in here, and it would go in the side of this water bottle into the mouth, and then out in the front. And I'll give you some closer details so you can see what I'm doing. So this gargoyle is ready for the next step, which would be the paper mache. I have two different types of paper mache I'm also gonna do to show you which one works better or not. You can paint on foam as well, like my tombstone tutorial I'm gonna do. Or if you've seen it, then you know there's only certain types of paints that you could use on styrofoam. The same goes for glue. So I'm just going to do some time-lapse videos. I'm going to stop and talk about stuff. You should know how to make an armature. If you don't, there's tons of tutorials out there to do it. You can crumble up newspapers into the shape of an animal. You can use toilet paper rolls. You can use cardboard. There's so many things you can use to make your skeleton of what you're doing, and then you paper mache over it. I'm thinking about making some pumpkins with the simple paper mache stuff, so if you want to check that tutorial out, go ahead. So let's start with gargoyle number two, since we have number one ready. Gargoyle number two is going to be made out of this box. He's going to be a little bit bigger. So the first step for my gargoyles is I made a face, and the other one I used the milk jug, or the Arrowhead jug. So this one I'm using a good old orange juice jug. I feel like it already has an evil shape to the eye, so what I'll do is I'll take my Sharpie, which I forgot, I'll take my Sharpie and I'll draw out a face. Then I'll cut out the head, and I'll leave the open back because that's where I want my smoke to go. And I'm going to cut off the nose and all this stuff, and then I'm going to shape my head first. After I do the head, then I'm going to do the neck, and then after that, I'll do the body. So everything's in steps. So the first thing is the face. Alright, so I got my head done, and show you a little closer. Here it is. Here's the side profile. Here's the back. So I put his ears kind of sideways like you would with a dog being mad. And I'm going to put the clay on here to sculpt like really like wrinkly eyebrows and when you're mad, that type of facial feature, can't talk. And then the mouth I taped shut, but after I paper mache it, I think I'm gonna go in and cut. It's gonna be hard with duct tape. If I can't do it, oh well, I'm not that upset over it. I might burn with my soldering iron a couple holes right here, so that way at least smoke can come out of his nose. I could also do that with the soldering iron and just do a little circle right here for the time being, just so I have something, so some smoke or incense or whatever I'm going to use can get out. But I think he's going to look pretty cool. So what I did is I actually cut with the razor blade right into there and made a hole in his mouth. And then those little pieces of teeth that I cut out, I taped on there. And then I'm taking little pieces of cardboard here and I'm shoving them actually underneath the teeth so they'll stick out a little bit and give it some depth. And then it should go the other way. Goes that way, and then I shove it in there. I'll use a tool and I'll poke it in there, and it actually is making the teeth stick out a little bit, and I'm going to put more and more in there until they stick out, so when I do paper mache it, there will be a little depth there with the teeth showing. So he's coming along. So while I'm getting my teeth all put on there, I'm going to turn on my fan, and I'll tell you why. So I'm going to be using the soldering iron, and it puts off some really bad, my dog's playing with the lizard, puts off some toxic fumes when you're using it on styrofoam or plastic, so you got to be really careful. But I am just going to go ahead and one hole, two holes. Poke two holes there. I don't know if it's gonna work. I never know if it's gonna work until I'm done. And if it doesn't work, I have a cool prop. If it does work, I have a cool prop that has effects. But I definitely know smoke will come out of his mouth. All right, that's that. Now we're gonna attach the head. All right, so I just duct taped his head the water bottle. That hole we made in the bottom, I put the water bottle in there and just duct taped it on there. So now we have a nice gargoyle. And now I'm going to put it in the styrofoam. Alright, so the styrofoam part, I did this. You could probably use whatever you want. I wanted to use the styrofoam because it was free and I was dumpster diving, but also it makes a good stand. So what I did for the other gargoyle is I drew out kind of like the silhouette of the body, and then I started cutting it out. And then when I cut it out, I was using ginseng knives. I use the soldering iron. I have a Dremel. I have every kind of tool that you could imagine, and I tried every single one. The soldering iron is awesome. It just melts like butter. And then the other cool thing is pumpkin carving tools. I went to Michael's, and in the foam section they had a foam. It looks like a soldering iron that they wanted like $40 for. This one, you could go to garage sales and find these things for cheap. And then the other foam cutting tools they had there was a whole pack for $30. And I said, that looks just like pumpkin carving tools. So I just went in my Halloween box and got my pumpkin carving tools. And then you just start hacking away. So that's what I'm gonna do now. So to cut the hole for your head, I'm just gonna look and see how thick your foam is. Put your water bottle there. Circle around it. And then you'll cut it. And you'll cut that hole right there, and then you will put that in there. And I royally messed up the sides. I forgot that this is the way he needs to go. And I messed up. So I'm gonna use my pumpkin carving tool. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and go the easy route and use the soldering iron. I do have my knife as well that I can stab with. It stinks, it's not healthy for you. So wear a mask. I turned my fan on full blast, and this is where it gets steamy. And now that I got most of my body cut out here, I gotta do the rest. And this guy, unlike my other gargoyle, I'm actually gonna give him arms. And so I'm gonna be using my good old poo noodles. And so I'm gonna cut those, and I'm going to use my skewers to stab them in there, and then I'm gonna use my styrofoam glue. Like I said, other glue doesn't work on styrofoam, it melts it. So make sure you buy the right glue. And this is just to keep them together until we start doing the whole paper mache process. After that happens, he hardens and he's fine. But this is just to get his skeleton made. The other thing I forgot to mention is these are gonna be on wine barrels. And so I have to make their feet a little different than if you were making your own and just on a table. For example, see how his feet are up higher than his body? It's because when I set him into the wine barrel, there's a lip there, and I wanted his claws to reach over the wine barrel, like almost like talons grabbing onto it. So when I add the points on there, that's why it will look like that. So when I'm making his feet, I actually have to measure for the surface that he's gonna be sitting on. And whatever you pick, you gotta keep that in mind as well. You just can't have legs sticking down unless you are setting it on something. So I'm gonna take him over to my wine barrel to measure and make sure he fits before I do arms. Okay, so this is my gargoyle shaping up. So instead of carving away parts like I did with the other gargoyle, this one I decided to make more three-dimensional and add more to it sticking out. Yet, that makes it more top-heavy, front-heavy, and it wants to fall over. So you just gotta remember to put a weight in the back, and it's gonna be fine if I add any effects in here. One cool thing about it being styrofoam, if I do like the humidifier, the moisture one, it's not gonna hurt the inside of this because I'm not gonna touch the inside. I'm just gonna touch the outside. So now it's just adding some details, and remember, this is all gonna be paper mache. So right now it looks like pool noodles and stuff, but I measured the feet. These are going to be the side feet, these are going to be the front feet with the talons coming over, and I just need to do some, like, something to do with the chest, and then of course I'll add these little things here to make some, looks like the elbows, and I'm going to add some glue on everything, and I'm going to add teeny little wings, and then it'll be, the next step would be to do the paper mache. And I just cut these off. So for the ending, I'm just gonna use chicken wire and I'm just gonna attach it to the back, but I'm gonna leave it open down here so I could reach in and out to put whatever I wanna put in there. So now it's just the chicken wire time, which I actually hate because I always stab myself, poke myself, cut myself, and but it works, and it can shape the body a little bit better that way. So I have no clue how long this video is gonna be. You gotta take in mind that this is gonna usually take someone more than one day, obviously. Just this part alone was taking me, I started at 1 and it's 4, just so you get an idea. Of course, I have little things to do. I'm a mom, so that takes priority. But I've actually pretty much been nonstop doing this the whole time. So it gives you an idea. One gargoyle takes one day, just the skeleton. the whole other part about doing the paper mache, that's probably going to be another 6 hours, maybe four, and then you got to let it dry and then you got to paint it. So this is a project that's going to take more than one day. I would say if you wanted to get it done pretty fast, it might take you 3 days. Of course, drying is one huge thing that you got to do. So I'm just attaching his back here, and I think I'm done. And then I will be off to getting him a paper mache. So exciting. So I forgot, the last part is the little wings. So I'm gonna make the wings out of cardboard. And what I do is just a good old box and trace out some wings and cut it out, trace out the other one with it, and then put it on here. We got wings. Voila, we have wings. And a big mess, huge, huge mess. So yes, he is all ready. I'm gonna add some rib cages here when we start doing the paper mache, but he is all ready to go. He is one handsome guy. I'm happy with him. Just hope he turns out the way I want him to. Okay. All right, welcome to my kitchen. I'm not quite ready to paper mache my gargoyles, but I do want to finish the wings so they don't look so flat. I wanted a little more three-dimensional. So this was my husband's idea. I was going to take rope and hot glue gun it on the edge like this. And my husband, the smart man he is, told me to get flex tubing. So right there. So my husband told me to get the flex tubing, and he said he had a better idea for me rather than hot gluing and burning myself, which I'm still gonna do anyway. So this flex tubing, let me see if I can show you again. Up close, here it is. This is the flex tubing. So it's got a hole and it already has a split in it. And I just use a little knife here and you can go down and open up the inside. But I'm just gonna run it along the edge of my gargoyle wings right now. So I'm just gonna run it along the edge of my gargoyle wings, and it will just stay there, and it will give it some good dimension. So I put the flex tubing on around the wings on each side, and I'll be honest to you, unless you have little fingers and you can spread them apart and put it on there without bending the cardboard, I'm not sure it's easier, gluing on rope or using the flex tubing, but it is on. I added a little hot glue there and there. I don't know. I'm going to have to try the rope and see which way I like the best. So it's your call. I would say if you have big hands, this was hard for me, and I have little hands, and I have nails. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take rope, and I know I usually try not to spend a lot of money on things, and I did have extra rope in the garage, but it could be my husband's, and he'll be like, why did you use my things for your crafts? Anyways, I am going to just add a little rope there. But of course, I'm going to hot glue gun it and burn my fingers. So the flex tubing was $3.99. The rope was a little bit more, $7.99. And still everything else except the duct tape I've used on my own. So now I'm gonna try this. And listen to music and dance. starting to think maybe my rope is too thin. So when I paper mache over this, I'm only gonna put one thin layer over and try to build up on these edges. I should have got thicker rope. Oh well, you learn from your mistakes. Still think it'll look cool. Well, we'll see if my husband ever watches these videos, because I'm gonna use his rope. It's a little thicker. And this gargoyle has little wings. I'm just gonna hot glue gun the rope on there. I'm gonna see if I like it better than the flexi stuff. So wish me luck. And hubby, I'm sorry if you see this. I'm not gonna use that much, only about not that much. So, you know how I say I learn as I go. If I were you, I'd build the wings first and then put them on. Welcome to my kitchen. Now I'm gonna make the paper mache paste. So it's simple, 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 and I'm sure there's a ton of tutorials out there, so we'll make this really, really fast, which I'm obviously not doing fast right now. This was my grandma's from like a long time ago, and I don't even know how to use it. There's gotta be a way to lock these things in, and they just fall right out. Oh, maybe. Shit. Okay, I gotta pause it while I figure this out. Alright, I figured it out. I had the wrong beaters in there. I had to call my mom. Now we're ready to roll. Okay, like I said, let's make this fast and easy. You got flour. Simple. This is gonna be a big project, but we're just gonna make a kind of small batch. 1, 2 cups of flour. That first one was a little big. 2 cups of flour. 1 cup of water. This is my own recipe. Stay Flow starch. 1 cup. So it's 1 cup of water, 1 cup of starch. The starch just, in my opinion, makes it set a little faster. Makes it stiff. So it's 2 cups of flour, 2 cups of fluid, a little bit of salt so it doesn't get moldy, maybe a little bit more, and if you want to add flavoring or smell, just kidding. If it needs more water, put more water. Definitely need more than what I'm making right now. So I'll probably double the batch, but this is just to show you really quick for my paper mache. And then I'm probably gonna start it tomorrow because it's in the afternoon right now and it's getting too hot, and I wanna start tomorrow morning before it's too hot. So I'm just gonna put this aside, remix it up in the morning, and voila, ready to go. Some people put it in the fridge. I don't like putting it in the fridge. It just seems to, I don't know. I don't like it, so I just leave it out. All right, now it's time for the fun part, the time where we get messy. So this is the paper mache part where I'm going to use a ton of newspaper. I have a trash bag over here, or a trash can full of newspapers that I actually picked off the side of the street. Someone was recycling a whole bunch of stuff, and I got a lot of the cardboard in boxes. And so I have the paste that we made, and I'm just going to remix that up really quick. And what I do is, instead of cutting up all the paper, I just rip it. I rip it, and I don't dip the paper in the paste. I cover what I'm going to paste first, and then I just take the paper and I put it over it with my wet hands. I dip my hands in the paste, not the paper, or it just is too much paste. And then after I do that, I'm gonna let it dry, and I actually have, and I'm lucky, let me tell you. I have a box, a big box, and it's so heavy. Can you see that? It is pretty much paper clay. It's a box of CelluClay. So I'm going to mix up this box of paper clay here. And same thing, water. All you do is water, and it's this powdery, messy stuff, water and this, and you mix it up in a bowl, and then I'm gonna paper clay it over the paper mache. So it's gonna be like two layers, and that way this one I can add more details and sand and all that stuff. I know most of you aren't that lucky to get a box full of paper clay, so to make paper clay is pretty easy. You just get a whole bunch of cheap toilet paper, some water, some joint compound, glue, and you just mix it all together. And I'll put a link of a tutorial that's really good on how to make paper clay. That's a whole nother thing, and there's a lot of videos out there to find on how to make paper clay. Or you could just paper mache it the way it is. So I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna do a time lapse because it's gonna take me some time. All right, so that was a little over an hour, and I paper mache'd most all of them. I'm gonna spray paint the foam, and I'm gonna spray paint the wings, so I didn't wanna cover them. And I left a hole in the back here because I wanna add lights. And I didn't paper mache over his eyes, because if you remember, I want them to glow. So the rest I'm gonna probably use the paper clay so I can add some details. And I'm seeing little parts that I need to fix here. But other than that, I'm gonna let them dry. It's starting to warm up around here. So, and I have that much left of what we made. So that was good. And I'm gonna let this dry, and then after it dries, I'm gonna put the paper clay on there and just make some eyebrows and some nose, like make a little pig nose, and that's where I'm gonna add a little detail. But yes, the paper mache part only took me a little over an hour. Now we're gonna do the next one. I started his face, but I haven't finished. And inside this bag is the paper clay that I did, and obviously it's way too wet, so I need to put some more in here. And then what I do is I just put it on his face and start shaping it and molding it and sculpting it. So I'm gonna put a little bit more in his bag. Remember, I didn't want smoke to come out of his eyes, so that's solid and it's gonna stay that way, and I'm gonna paint it. But I do want smoke to come out of his mouth and his nostrils. There's the feet. All right, it's time to paint my gargoyle. And I did the other one, and I like to use Drylock. And it already gives it a stone-like texture to it. So everything that's paper mache looks like stone. And I like to mix it up, and I like to get white, and you can get gray. But I like white because that's my first coat, and then I color it. Let's see, I already did the other gargoyle. And then I color it gray for the second coat. That way I know I've covered everything twice. So give it a good mix. And after you mix it, I just buy the cheap 60-cent paintbrushes and go to town. Make sure your paper mache is dry. So I've let this guy dry out in the sun for a couple days. We had some really wet, overcast days with a lot of fog, which was just not good for paper mache in this. So I let him sit in the sun for a couple days and dry out, and now he's really hard. And I already did one coat of the white on him, and now I'm going to go ahead and mix up some of the gray. And then I'm going to go over it with the gray. So I just take the Dry-Lock and I mix it with black acrylic. Mix it all up and then I'll go over it with that. That's what I'm gonna do right now. Mix the paint. So I'm just gonna take some cheap paint and my cheap brush, and I'm just gonna add a little black details to it before I spray paint it. Easy, easy. I'm gonna get in between the toes and just like some details here, just to like give it a little extra. Something that this spray paint can't really get. Before you spray paint it with the stone spray paint, you have to scrape the eyes back to its clear self. So I just use my fingernails and I just scrape away the dry lock and the paint that I got on there. And then it should just be that water bottle or orange juice bottle or whatever you use underneath. It should be clear plastic. And you're not gonna paint over it a lot. You're gonna use the spray paint and you're gonna lightly go over it once. Only once, lightly, just so it appears to look like stone. So lightly that when you put the light in there, it's gonna light up and you won't. So during the day, it will look like stone. At night, they will glow. So you gotta do that before you spray paint it. So see the eyes, how I scraped them? Now they're clean, and now I'm gonna go over it with a thin coat of spray paint. Right here is gargoyle number 2. I don't have the light for him yet, so I'm actually using a headlamp on him, but I haven't ordered it. But there he is smoking. You can kind of get an idea what his eyes look like. I really appreciate it if you stuck through the whole video, because that was probably one of the longest videos I've ever made, and it got a little crazy and a little silly there, so thank you. You see how I painted it? Remember how I painted the eyes? So during the day it looks like stone, and at night they light up. Let me take the light off and you will see what I mean. There you go. Same thing with his eyes. I painted it over slightly, so when we shut the light off, it just looks like stone.
He's a happy little guy, isn't he?